A very good afternoon to all of you and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. And in this tutorial, I will show you that how you can enter bank entries in Tele ERP 9. In my previous tutorial, I have shown you that how you can create new ledger accounts and then use the same ledger accounts to enter vouchers. So in this tutorial, I am going to show you that how you can use Contra Voucher entries for bank to cash, cash to bank, or bank to bank entries. So let's get started. And first of all, as I have started Tele ERP 9, as I have shown you that we are using an educational version of Tele. So I am going to enter on work in education mode. And here I'm going to select the company in which I want to work. So for that, I am going to press enter on the select company. And here it will show you all the companies that you have created in previous steps. So here we have this KCI with the 10,001 number from 1st April 2017 to 31st March 2018. And here it is showing you the folder path where the entire data is going to save. So I am going to press enter on KCI. So first of all, I am going to create a new ledger account for the bank. And for that, I am going to accounts information, ledger accounts, and then hit enter on the create. So I have opened a new account in Punjab National Bank. So I am here going to type the name of the bank. And then we have to choose the group. In the under section, here you can see the list of groups, where on the top you can see three groups related to the bank. First one is bank account. Second one is bank OCC, which stand for over cash credit. And then third one is bank OD, which is for overdraft. So it depends on the account type that you have opened in the bank. So this account is a current account. So I am going to use bank accounts. The bank account group is used for saving and current accounts, and bank OCC and OD are used when you have a bank account with a credit limit. And I will discuss about them later on. For now, I am going to use bank accounts as we have this current account in Punjab National Bank. So here it is asking you for the bank details and you can fill out all the entries here. I am going to leave all of them as it is. And then I am going to save this ledger account. So after opening the new account, the first step I did is I deposited a minimum balance amount in my account. And for that, we are going to enter a voucher. And that amount was cash deposited to the bank. So for that, I go back by pressing the escape key. And here I am going to enter into accounting vouchers. In my previous tutorial, I have shown you that how you can use payment and receipt entries. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you contra entries, which are used for bank to bank, bank to cash, or cash to bank entries. So I am going to press F4. And what entry we have is, I have deposited a cash amount of rupees 1000 to Punjab National Bank. So in my previous tutorial, I have shown you the payment and receipt voucher, but one thing you have might have noticed that you can't see credit or debit in this voucher entry list. Here you only see two things, accounts and particulars, and there is no mention of credit and debit entries. So by default, if you choose payment voucher and type an account name on the top in the account section, then it will automatically get credited, and the account ledger name that you will use in the particular section, that account will automatically get debited. So this is the default behavior of Tele ERP 9. Let me show you about the receipt entry. If I press F6, then whatever ledger name you will use in the account section, in the receipt voucher, it will get debited. And the ledger name that you will use in the particular section in the receipt voucher, this account will get credited. So in the contra entry vouchers, if you type an account name in the account section, let's say here I type cash, and in the particular section, I type the bank account name. And if I press space here, then you can see the list of ledger accounts. And one thing you should notice here that you are only seeing two accounts related to cash in hand and bank accounts groups. So in Contra entry, you will always see only those ledgers which fall under cash in hand, bank accounts, bank OCC or bank OD groups. So here I'm going to choose Punjab National Bank and going to enter an amount of rupees 1000. Here you can fill the rest of the details according to your entry, like check number. And here I can type the narration. Going to hit enter and it is asking for me to save the changes. I'm going to hit enter, yes. And let's see the cash book display, accounts book, cash book. And here you can see that we have now a balance of amounting to rupees 2902.25 paisas. And this entry shows that the account name that you write on the top in the account section will get debited. In Contra entry, the ledger name that you will define in the account section will get debited, and the ledger name that you will define in the particular section will get credited. So as I have deposited an amount of rupees 1000 in Punjab National Bank, so what I will do, I will type the bank name on the top in the account section and cash in the particulars. So as I have changed this entry through the cash book, as I will save the changes, it will reflect the entire accounting books in the real time. So here you can see now the balance is reduced to 902.25 rupees. And in the Punjab National Bank, you see a balance of rupees 1000 debit. Now let's enter another entry in Contra Vouchers. And this time I am going to open a new account that will be State Bank of India, which is our second account in another bank. So I will go to accounts information, ledger, create. And here I am going to type the name of the bank. As rest of the entries are same, like group name is bank account, and I don't want to change any other things. So I am going to press Control A to directly save this entry. Now I will go back to voucher entry. And the next voucher is, I have deposited a amount of rupees 500 in State Bank of India. So I will type State Bank of India. As you can see, you can only see a list of three ledger accounts which fall into bank accounts and cash in hand. So here I'm going to type State Bank of India, particular cash amounting to rupees 500. As you can see the current balance here, the cash balance is reduced to 402.25 rupees. And in the State Bank of India, you can see a debit balance of rupees 500. So if I go to display, accounts book, cash book, then you can see all the entries related to cash and bank accounts. And here we have 500 rupees debit balance in the State Bank of India. The next entry is, I have transferred a amount of rupees 500 from Punjab National Bank to State Bank of India. So when you do bank to bank transfer, so for the same, you will use the Contra entry. And as I have shown you that the ledger name that you will write on top will get debited. So as we are depositing amount to State Bank of India, so I will write the State Bank of India name in the account section and Punjab National Bank name in the particular section. And here I am going to type 500. Here I am going to type the narration. And the last entry that I am going to fill here in the Contra is cash withdrawal entry. And for that, I am going to type the name of cash account in the account section and bank name in the particular section. And here I'm going to write the amount. So let's see the balances. Display, accounts book, cash book. And as you can see that we have now a cash balance of rupees 702.25 rupees. And in the Punjab National Bank, we have 500 rupees. And in State Bank of India, we have 700 rupees. And if you press enter, then you can see the monthly detail of the ledger account. And here you can see that in the April month, we debited a total amount of rupees 1000 and credited the 300 amount, and the balance we have is 700. And same, we can see the Punjab National Bank detail. We deposited 1000 rupees on 2nd April 2017, and then we transferred rupees 500 from Punjab National Bank to State Bank of India. That is why it is showing rupees 500 in the credit side. And here you will see the second ledger name, and on the top you will see the ledger name that you have opened. And let me show you the daybook. And here you will see all the entries of that particular date. And here you can see the entries that I have filled recently. Two entries we have in cash and two entries we have in bank. So this is how we use Contra payment and receipt vouchers in Tally ERP 9. In my next tutorial, I will show you how to use journal, sale and purchase voucher entries. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching.